It's my feel good breakfast show.
San Bonani to Melanga Busheni. Hello. Welcome back to your feel good breakfast show, Espresso, here on SABC3. Our next guest is a superstar from making videos of herself singing from her parents' bedroom at the start of lockdown to having over 2 million views on social media and releasing a debut single. British song, South African singer and songwriter Laura Nordstrom has become a massive online success in a short space of time. Her creative music videos of her singing jazzy freestyles to soulful R&B songs and poems have become a hit on social media platforms such as TikTok and Instagram. We get to know the singer and songwriter a little bit better before she performs 3 of her viral hits this morning. Please give a warm Espresso welcome to Laura Nordstrom. Hey!
How are you doing, Lauren?
I'm good. I'm really excited to be here. So thank you so much.
It's really good seeing you in person and in your life, because what I did see from you was an incredible video in March 2020. Mm. You were singing at your parents' place. It was during the lockdown, of course. And it went absolutely viral. Something like 2 million views on TikTok.
Wow. Yeah, it was crazy.
Was that the agenda? Was that the game plan? Like, I'm going to make a viral video? Or was it just like, whoa, what's happening?
No, not at all. I was just, you know, there was nothing to do during lockdown. And I was like, you know what, I might as well just put my things out there. And there was maybe like 100 views for about 6 hours, and then it just started to skyrocket and it just took off. Me and my family were sat in the kitchen just shaking. We couldn't believe it. So it was a shock.
So while people were baking banana bread and doing other things during the lockdown period, how did you manage to get, you know, your creative juices flowing and decided, you know what, let me use my talent for something?
Yeah, that's a good question. It was crazy, you know. Previously, before lockdown, you know, I had access to so many resources, and I felt so overwhelmed. And then when we went into lockdown, I literally had nothing but a camera. And with all that confinement, I felt so free to do what I wanted, you know. I found a lot of creativity in that kind of limitation, and I think that's where it all stemmed from.
It's quite ironic, though, if the way you mention it, because you think as an artist you want physical freedom to free your expression and your thoughts, but yet that confinement, I guess, forced some beautiful focus.
Yeah, it did, and no one was more surprised than me.
Really. Now, something that's surprising to me is the first time I heard your voice, I can't like put my finger on it. Is it jazz? Is it soul? Is it blues? Is it pop? I don't know. What is it about? Like, where is your influence, and who is it that's influencing your style? Is it something that's just completely raw?
Yeah, well, I grew up, you know, I started doing musicals at the age of 7, but I listen to like hip hop, and you know, a lot of my favorite artists are, you know, Drake, The Weeknd. I listen to a lot of hip hop, but also jazz, and you know, grew up on Whitney, so it's all over the place, you know. So I get influence from all different places in my life.
We'd love to hear it. And something that we obviously cannot overlook is the English accent that you have, okay? Tell us about your life in England. What are you doing there, and what made you come back down to South Africa?
Well, so my dad's British and my mom's South African.
Okay.
And so that's where the half-half it comes from. But I actually grew up in Dubai, and so, you know, that's went to international school, and that's where the accent comes from. I stick out like a sore thumb in Cape Town, so.
I think it gives you a nice exotic appeal. And I must say, you mentioned something about studying film and media earlier in your day. So. Yeah. For you, and when I watch your videos, I see how you carry yourself. There's a confidence. Mm-hmm. You mentioned you started at the age of 7 years old, so you've got the experience too. Yeah. So I can imagine being in front of the cameras, a comfortable thing for you. So is there an expectation of maybe transferring over to film and some acting as well?
I mean,
you've ticked all the other boxes, clearly.
Well, you know, I actually, there was a point where I really wanted to go into acting. But what I love about music is that I can do that through music videos. You know, I can be a character on a music video, and then I can also, you know, edit and direct these things by myself. So it's I get to kind of expand all my avenues and do all the different mediums of art through just one, you know,
channel.
Yeah.
Unfair, actually. You get to like shoot like 10 movies, one album.
Imagine.
That's awesome.
We love a multi-talented queen. Laura Nordstrom is still here on your Feel Good Breakfast show. Do not go anywhere, because she's about to uplift the feel goodness here in studio with 3 wonderful performances. So make sure you don't go anywhere.